clothing optional moment?
What could it be?
Sorry, fans, it hasn't happened yet. You're just going to have to keep watching TV's twistiest, most tweetable thriller. No shoes, no shirt? No problem. Number four, getting caught in the rain repeatedly.
You're acting like a lunatic!
He's not shirtless, not...
This maybe disturbs me a little. JD counsels your children about...
No.
He beats regularly with them once
a week. Now you're going too far.
He has nothing to do with my children. Nothing.
We read that in New York.
Say gonzo shit cock on the air. That's really the only reason why
Sweet of you. But can I say one thing?
No,
would
we're
you say to someone
Ryan.
That wanted to go into filmmaking, that had a can...
And he gets in there, and he tackles the subject.
Yeah. Right?
And he is a real reporter. I mean, the guy worked for years.
Yeah.
And that's my point. Even to be a goofy reporter on our stations, you have to...
Personality dysmorphia.
Yeah, I'm like, why would De Niro want to talk to me? You know?
Right,
I'm
a douche. Exactly, yeah.
Right.
But so we had this dinner, and I was on the way home, and I stopped to get, you know, sick personality dysmorphia.
Yeah, I'm like, why would De Niro want to talk to me? You know?
Right,
I'm a douche.
Exactly, yeah.
Right.
But so we had this dinner, and I was on the way home, and I stopped to get, you know, sick...
Harvey and, you know, Louis C.K.
I got to go to Mike Myers, David Carvey. I'm not worthy. I got to do that to them.
But to put that in context, Mike Myers...
It looks good. Like, this could be your whole renaissance. I mean, this could be the biggest time in your career. Really could.
Yeah, I mean, the way the business has changed, it could change. Like, J.D., he cares about movies.
Right.
He has a taste in regards to... film or cinema that I respect. And
SNL 40th, Paul McCartney played, and Taylor Swift, and Elvis Costello, and Ariana Grande, and Miley Cyrus, and
Bill Murray on the tambourine.
Bikinis.
Huh?
You know what I mean? It's like the perfect, to me, that's the perfect combo. Brains and beauty.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, man.
You found it. You found it in Bev.
Yeah. Hey, listen, who is that, Gary? Yeah, this is from your first film you directed.
Yeah.
JD1.
Thank you.
This is how important you are to me. The first film that I wrote and directed.
I think all...
That kind of freaked me out a little bit.
Yes.
Like, it doesn't matter what she wears there.
No,
right.
No, it's a little
But
unnerving.
If she looks too hot, I mean, she could really, you know, she could cause a distraction.
Too, and that translates in a work manner into no days off, no scenes off. I worked an 80-hour week one week, which New York, and it's a big point of connection with my mother and I, oddly enough, Howard Stern, but yeah. Go on.
Yeah, I know you were on that birthday show that he just won a Webby for.
Yeah.
All right, spin a bolt. Take the flag down, boys. Have his order. You heard him. Let's do it. And I'll say that I'd rather.
There are dreams I must gather. You too. And I think people are saying we're in a golden age of television. I mean, it's some of the best material out there.
Trying to boost ratings.
You're trying to reach the audience.
What is the reason for the podcast
appearance? The podcast is that everybody wants to be a star. Everybody wants to
and
have
And everybody
something.
Thinks they have something to say. Don't talk to my knees. You gotta let me go. You gotta help me. I'm gonna set me free.
two moments where you kiss guys, which is sort of edgy, and you probably really had a... I mean,
you went to all that trouble.
Went to all that trouble.
Yeah. Truthfully, yeah.